Good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to show you some things that I found personally are interesting to know. So first we start with an LED, and it is connected with a series resistor of 1 ohm to measure the current through it. And I'm placing a signal of 10 kilohertz pulse. And this is the wave that we get out. So the blue is the current and yellow is the voltage. Now I was asking myself, does a LED have reactive power? And I don't seem to see that is the case at this frequency with this LED. So we can see that the current and voltage are both at the same time. Now, what happens when we go to a higher frequency? So I'm going now to the 1 megahertz. I have to set my leading and trailing times because this signal generator doesn't do that automatically. Like that. Let me zoom a little bit out. And now we can see that there is a lot of difference with the current measurement. So I didn't change any settings of the current measurement, and you see that we are really having spikes. Now the disadvantages of this is of course that we are using much more power at those moments over here, but we can also see that there is not much or no reactive power in it, but it is not a constant use of current. So I'm going to try and show you what happens when we are using an Avramenko plug setup. But what I want to show you is that it is interesting to know that if we would work with higher frequencies, that we must keep in mind that we can give higher current pulses. Now, of course, we are not using pulses like this one on the Avramenko plugs, but because it will be more sine wave. So therefore, I want to show you what will happen when we use an Avramenko plug. So going to the next part. So what we are now looking at is when I use an Avramenko plug. So I added 2 diodes. So I'm only using the signal output of my signal generator. So as you can see, the ground connection is not connected. I'm going to this diode over here, the one N4148, going to the LED, then going back to the series resistor to measure the current. And then I have a diode back to our connection of the signal generator. In that way, we have the Avramenko plug connected. And as you can see, when we use pulses, then we have those current spikes again, just like with without that Avramenko plug. But of course, in our circuit, we are using sine wave because it's the output of a resonance system. So when we go to sine wave, then we see that we don't have that current spikes anymore, and we have just a few peaks, but that are very low. But as you can see, we also are not able to see the voltage because I didn't make any changes like with the pulses. So I need to go and put the position a little lower to see what happens with the voltage on our Avramenko plug setup. So this is what we can see when we use an Avramenko plug setup. So we see that the voltage rises a little bit and then goes back down. Of course, this is only half wave because we have only one half wave rectifying. But this is what happens when we use that at the 1 megahertz system. And that is important to know. I found that because we can see that we don't have those current spikes when we have sine wave and an Avramenko plug. So going to the next part of the video. In this part of the video, I'm going to show you that we must be careful with our measurements that we have seen in the previous part of the video, because the ground connection of my oscilloscope has created an antenna, because I was wondering if my LED would be on when I just use this on the signal generator with no other connection at all. But as you can see, when we add an antenna, so I have this clip wire over here, you can see that we are using it as an antenna. So at the moment that we are connecting our ground connection of the scope, we immediately see that how much influence we create on it. Also, look at the scope. So our measurement is clearly influencing our setup. So I have to think in how far we can rely on the measurements that we have just seen. It will be hard to measure, because every time I will add a meter, I will add an antenna to it. So, because as you can see, just a wire is enough to have an antenna on it and have better output. And when I touch it, of course, I have a bigger antenna and we have much more output. So I hope that I can conclude from my measurements that the current spikes are not there, because when we look at, even when we connect our scope, then we can see that that what we are measuring is a sine wave. So they're not spikes. So that this is again the measurement as it was done before. And as you can see, the LED is much brighter. And then we have those current measurements over there. So it's my question at the moment on how far I can trust on the fact that we don't have spikes at that higher frequency. But I show you everything so you can make your own conclusions. So we are going to the next part of the video. In this part of the video, I'm going to show you the answer to my question that I had myself. What would happen if we use a signal generator that is not grid connected, so working on a battery? And we again see that the LED goes on. The brightness is less than with the signal generator connected to the grid. But the results are the same, in the sense that we can see that we can light up the LED from that one wire. And also, when we use an antenna, then we can see that we have a much better output. So it is not really only resonance related, because I don't have any resonance created in this system, because I just used 1 megahertz. I can show you what happens when we go to 2 megahertz, for example. Or it will be a multiple, so I will go to 1.5 megahertz. And then I will touch the wire, and again you will see. And I can go to every frequency. So I'm now going to 1.7 megahertz. And you see it also works. If I had resonance then necessary, then I couldn't do that on all those frequencies. So going to 2.1, and again you see. But what we also see is the higher the frequency, the brighter the LED goes. So I can try to see how far I can go. So we are now at the maximum, and that is 15 megahertz. And as you can see, the LED is much brighter. So the higher the frequency we go, the more power we have on our LED. So that is also important to know when we are going to do the experiments with the one wire and the resonance part. But this experiment showed me that it is not really resonance that is coupling to earth ground, because I can have coupled it to earth ground over here. And as you can see, we have that same. And we are not connected in any way to earth ground on the single generator side. This is, as you can see, this clip is not connected. Now, why I have those ups and downs in the brightness, I don't know. But as you can see, the brightness is much higher, and maybe it's because it's working on its maximum. So going to 8 megahertz. That is more stable. So it was the frequency generator that is working at its maximum output. That was the problem. But as you can see, when we connect to earth ground, so the LED is back changing. Something is influencing my earth ground connection, and I don't know what. But we can clearly see that it's not really resonance related, because I don't need resonance to light up that LED with the Avramenko plug. So I think it's a bad connection in the wire over here. I had some troubles in the past when there is. I think it's more of a bad connection in the wire. Anyway, the most important things that I've learned from this is that it's not really resonance that is going to cause our circuit to be able to have a reference to earth ground. It will be always there the moment we have a frequency signal. When the higher the output frequency is, the more output we have on the LED, so that is also shown. We don't have the current spikes compared to when you are using pulses. I want to add something extra to the video that I experienced with my experiments. So we have the signal generator on battery. We have the output going to the Avramenko plug, then going to the LED. And this is our earth ground connection. No earth ground connection on this side. Now, I wanted to know if when I'm using a plate in this situation, that it will also help the LED on the output. And that is indeed the case. So when I connect this wire of the ground connection of the single generator to this plate, now this plate is not connected to earth ground directly. There will be a capacitive coupling, of course, to earth ground, but it is not directly connected. And as you can see, the LED goes up in brightness. So this is influencing our result. Now, when I add a longer wire to this, so this is I guess 10 to 20 meters of earth ground wire. When I connect this extra to the signal, and you can see that we have also a better output. I will release it again, so I will touch it a few times. So you can see that the brightness goes up the moment I connect it. So I don't have a situation where I'm creating resonance in a coil, and yet you can see that the RF signal directly has a relationship to earth ground. Also in this situation, because I can go up in the frequency and the LED will go on. Or stay on. Now, there is a difference when at some frequencies, but I don't know if that is because the wire length that we are foreseeing here has at those frequency a negative influence. So that I'm not sure where I can place that. The cause of that change, because at 8 megahertz I have now a little bit less, so I will go back from 1 megahertz. So 1 megahertz, 2, the brightness goes up, 3, slightly, 4, slightly, 5, slightly, and then 6, a little bit lower, 7, a little bit lower, 8 stays approximately the same, and 9 we have more. but this can come because the traveling of our signal over here, then the wavelength becomes an influence, and when we then create some negative influence, then of course the LD will go down. But at the moment I have not enough insight to understand what's really happening. So if you know what's really happening, please let me know. The only thing I can think of at the moment is the speed of the electricity that is running back and forth over here. So please let me know if you know it. Thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next video.